सुचारुवक्त्रमण्डलं सुकर्णरत्नकुण्डलं सुचर्चिताङ्गचन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनम्। नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनं। सुदीर्घनेत्रपङ्कजं शिखेशिखण्डमूर्धजम् अनङ्गकोटिमोहनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनम्। नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनम्। सुनासिकाग्रमौक्तिकं स्वच्छन्ददन्तपङ्क्तिकं नवाम्बुदाङ्गचिक्कनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनम्। नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनम्। करेण वेणुरञ्जितं गतिकरेन्द्रगञ्जितं दुकूलपीतशोभनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनम्। नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनम्। त्रिभङ्गदेहसुन्दरं नखद्युतिसुधाकरम् अमूल्यरत्नभूषणं नमामि नन्दनन्दनम्। नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनम्। सुगन्ध अङ्गसौरभं पुरोविराजिकौस्तुभं स्फुरश्रीवत्सलाञ्छनं नमामि नन्दनन्दनम्। Namami Nandanandanam, Namami Nandanandanam, Namami Nandanandanam, Namami Nandanandanam. Vrindavana Sunagaram Vilasanugavasasam Surendra Garva Mochanam Namami Nandanandanam Namami Nandanandanam Namami Nandanandanam Namami Nandanandanam Namami Nandanandanam Vrajangana Sunayakam Sadasukha Pradayakam Jaganmanah Pralobhanam Namami Nandanandanam Namami Nandanandanam Namami Nandanandanam Namami Nandanandanam Namami Nandanandanam Shri Nandanandanashtakam Pathedya Shraddhayanvita Tarit Bhavaptim Dustaram Labheta Dangri Yukmakam Namami Nandanandanam Namami Nandanandanam Namami Nandanandanam Namami Nandanandanam Shri Nandanandanashtakam ki jai. This is the 9th verse. Just keep it there, hold it for a moment. So this is called Nandanandanashtakam, 8 verses glorifying the son of Nanda. Then why are there 9 verses here? That is called the Phalashruti. So the last verse after the main song usually tells us about the benefits of singing and hearing this composition. So here we are told about how we can easily cross the seemingly insurmountable ocean of material existence and attain eternal residence at the lotus feet of Krishna. So everyone sitting in this room has attained the eternal residence at the lotus feet of Krishna. Not as easy as that. We have to work for it. But the gate is opened. Now we have to move. Hare Krishna. I offer pranam. Pranam means obeisances. I offer my obeisances to Sri Nandanandana, whose face is extremely lovely, from whose beautiful ears hang jeweled earrings, and whose entire body is anointed with fragrant chandan or sandalwood. I offer obeisances to Sri Nandanandana, whose elongated eyes are beautiful like a fully bloomed lotus, the top of whose head is exquisitely adorned with peacock feathers and who enchants millions of cupids, Kamadevas. We are talking of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, by the way. This is the conception of God. not simply as one who is an old man holding up the earth and who simply gives everyone the reactions to their karma, who punishes the evildoers. Krishna's real business is enjoying life with his devotees in the spiritual world. I offer pranam or obeisances to Nandanandan, from whose beautiful nose hangs an elephant pearl, whose teeth are immensely effulgent, whose bodily complexion is more beautiful and lustrous than a fresh rain cloud. I offer obeisances to Nandanandan, whose lotus hands hold the flute, whose lingering gait defeats even that of an impassioned elephant, and whose dark limbs are beautified by a yellow shawl. Next. I offer obeisances to Nandanandana, whose threefold bending posture is exquisitely elegant, the effulgence of whose toenails put to shame even the moon, and who wears invaluable jewels and ornaments. I offer obeisances to Nandanandana, whose body exudes an especially beautiful fragrance, and whose broad chest is adorned with the Kaustubha jewel and the mark of Sri Vatsa. I offer pranam to Nandanandana, the expert lover of Vrindavan, who performs immaculate pastimes and who is attired in clothes which are suitable for those pastimes and who pulverize the pride of Indra. I offer obeisances to Nandanandana, who as a lover of the Vraja Gopis perpetually delights them and who enchants the mind of all living entities. Whoever regularly recites this Sri Nandanandanashtakam will easily cross the seemingly insurmountable ocean of material existence and attain eternal residence at the lotus feet of Krishna. Who wants to attain the residence at the eternal feet of Krishna? Okay, so we must sing this song.